first time, it's taken a lot for me mentally to be able to put myself out there again after what happened to me in 2015. But I'm so happy to be back making music, and the support from fans, from like you said, Frank, Dina, Devo, the entire BT family has been insane. And
this new path. Can you tell us a little bit about that?
Oh, I feel like I've been telling the story so much, and it's like, it's great. So, you know, I do the OB, I get invited. Like I said, I was here that day. I remember telling you guys, I'm going to blow the roof off of history. On that.
Because history was hosting, just the context.
Yes.
It was a Drake show, but it was like the history, ironically enough, of Canadian rap,
yeah,
hip hop,
yeah,
and R&B, yeah, and you were part of that class, yeah, show.
So I go on, and the place erupts. I did exactly what I said I was going to do, and I murdered it. I killed him. And so I come off stage, and Drake pulls me aside. He's watching from the balcony. And I come up, and pulls me aside. He's like, "Yo, Shawn Desmond, you're different, bro." And I said, "What?" And he's like, "You're different." And I'm like, "Drake, I don't know what that means." And he's like, "Did you hear those people, man? They love you. Those songs, even the older ones, Shook, Get Ready, they sound brand new again. What are you doing, man?" And I'm like, "Drake, I've unfortunately lost the passion and the love. I love music, I hated the music business." He's like, "I get that, but squash that spot. Shawn Desmond needs to make music again now. The people need you, man." And let me tell you, that day, after that day, my phone, and I'm not talking about messages from people on Instagram, which was happening, but from the heads of streaming services, Spotify, Apple Music, "We were at the show, you blew us all away, is there music coming?"